Right, so these connectors here, they've generally got 4 bolts in the top, okay? Then when you come back underneath, they'll have screws into these connectors here, and then there's also another screw there. So once you've got all those done, they'll pop out. So this is the KLE, which is subject to a recall, and we can see here how the corrosion's getting right on the inside of the unit. You can see it all down in there. So obviously the seal that was around there just wasn't doing its job. Right, there you go, that's the inside of it all. So as we can see here, this is the seal and all the corrosion that's getting in behind it. So on the whole, so far when we've been taking bits apart, everything that's inside has been in very good condition. This is the only bit, but obviously that's why it's being recalled. So there you go. So finally managed to get all the screws out. A couple of them I'd had to drill out, but lots of Loctite on there. So you've got to get some heat on there, get that Loctite mounting, and then you can get the screws out. But let's take the lid off. Oh, there we go. All right, let's get you over here. So here we can see the amount of corrosion that is in these, and that is that's why they were subject to that recall. So obviously that seal on both sides just wasn't up to the job, so letting moisture in and we've got some corrosion happening. There we go, there's the 2 high voltage connectors, little safety loops for that, to make sure the plug's in properly. We've got some, so this is actually for the I believe for the air conditioning circuit, the air conditioning gas that is used. Got these smaller connectors here, so I think that's part of that, but that I could utilize as a cooling plate possibly. Let's have a look, we'll have a think, but I'm gonna disconnect all of these parts now and then flip it over and start stripping out the other parts as well. So really interesting for anyone that is curious about these things. We can see here that the nice big thick wires merely join the 2 high voltage connectors together, and then we've got these thinner wires that come in and go down into the box. So we'll have a look at where they go in a minute, but yeah, I thought that was quite interesting. Right, okay, so here we see the positive and negative connection, and this is the innards of the KLE on a BMW i3. Okay, let's see if we can strip them out. Try and make some space. And we can see here, this is where the wires come through, those interlock wires, and guess what it says? Interlock. So this little plate here, just lifts out. It's just sort of clipped in, so that can lift out the way. And then we can see even more corrosion and bits and pieces around the side. But yeah, now we can get to these bits. So once you've got all the screws out, there's quite a few in there, you can gently start to lift that top board out. Just be aware that there's these long pins here. Okay, so they need to come up quite vertically in that corner, just to let them come out. All right, but yeah, there's another couple there, couple there. So just gently, gently ease it up, and then that will come out. Again, we can see with this board here, we've got all these long pins that we've got to be really careful of, that when we take the board out, it's nice and we pull it upwards, don't twist it. So there we go, we've finally got the all the screws out. A bit fiddly in this bit, but hopefully that can lift out now. Ooh. Okay, one-handed might not work. There you come. There we go. So I'm gonna carefully put these back together now, just to help protect the pins and whatnot. But I might have to use two hands for that. So there we are, I've managed to get those three boards back together. I haven't pushed it down too tight, but as you can see, you gotta make sure all these pins line up, so it's really quite tricky, and you gotta be super careful. But now you get to see the box. All right, so then we've got these connectors on the side here, and again suffering really badly with corrosion, but got a rubber seal there. Yeah. So what you've got to do is, I squirted a bit of WD-40 down there, and then if we look from the inside, you can see there's a bit of a flat there. So you can try and get a drift onto that and then punch it out from the inside, rather than trying to sort of get it from the outside. All right, so I'm just gonna do that again, but that's what I did there. It's just got the punch onto that flat bit just in there. I haven't got so much room to work in here, so I have to put the camera down. That's the KLE stripped, pretty much. Well, I hope you've enjoyed watching this episode and enjoy watching some of the things that we're stripping down off of the i3. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and we'll see you next time.